Hey guys, Andrew here, and welcome back to an episode of Spyro 3. When we last left off, we had just traveled to the new land, Meadow something, Midday Gardens World. And now it is time to do the only thing that you should do, which is 100% the overworld before you go anywhere else. Otherwise, you're going to forget all the places you've already checked, and then it's going to be a harder time to go back and find all the stuff that you missed. So let's do that now. There's a lot of love I have so far for Spyro's overworlds. I think the first overworld is small but manageable. I think it's interesting. It looks good. It has an aesthetic that... I'm sorry, did I just break that? Okay. That was weird. It has a nice aesthetic to it. I like it. And again, Andrew is just talking about level design because he's such a boring jerkhole. All right. So here's the thing. Is one of the most frustrating things about platformers is that back in the day, they were always centrally located on, or most of the timeless greatest platformers are stuck in a hellish purgatory on old consoles, never to come back, because I don't know, their developers don't exist anymore, the IPs are owned by people who just don't give a shit, or a combination of all three. And so it's really unfortunate, because I want to, you know, like I was talking about earlier, of going through and looking for or going back and playing like Gex or Croc. I can't just do that, because I need to go through the entire effort of, you know, setting up my PlayStation 1, getting it, making sure it works, getting the games for PlayStation 1.
Spyro, Zoe told me that if we hit that doodad up there, the portal will open. Why don't you try spitting this rock at it?
Okay. Gross. You have arms. Why do I have to put this thing in my mouth and spit it? Okay. Thanks, dude. Since they're stuck on this this old purgatory system that I may or may not... Well, I don't have... So I only have one Gex game, which is I have Gex Enter the Gecko, but I don't have the second Gex. And I don't have Crocs. Or Croc. I also don't own Crocs. But I'm stuck, and I need to... I've been, like, looking at it, and like, okay, how do I do this? Am I gonna have to emulate it? Because I have a controller, I have a USB to PlayStation controller thing that we used, that I bought in the assumption that we may use it for the bouncer at the time, because me and Keith tried recording the bouncer, and turns out trying to record really old consoles is a pain in the dick, because there's a lot of weird screen tearing and issues like that, and you have to just, like, there's so much fucking work involved in recording really, really, really old games, and it sucks. And I hate it.
My good friend Spyro. The sorceress caught this naughty bird letting off rockets in her fireworks factory. But I'm willing to release him into your custody, provided you pay his outstanding fines. Ha ha! What a sucker! That is, it's a far, far better thing you do today, Spyro, than you have ever done. And, well, so forth, etc. You get the idea.
Sergeant Byrd, 90068. Awaiting orders, sir.
I think you'll have to find your commanding officer for that. Hey, what are those things?
These are the latest military hardware. DBX-9 rocket launchers, state-of-the-art.
So why didn't you use them to escape?
Because I have limited ammo, and I wanted to conserve it. For this. Say, where'd you come from? I thought dragons had all been dead for 1,000 years or something.
Well, the rumors of our extinction were slightly exaggerated. We just wanted a little peace and quiet.
Well, if it's peace and quiet you want, you should stay clear of my homeworld for a bit. I reckon I'll be blowing up Rhinox for weeks. Cheerio!
That's a very good attitude to have there, Spyro. I also feel when I hear him. I don't know. I really don't like the military trope. The super soldier. Like, I'm dedicated to some cause that's unnecessary and... Anyways, that's not the relevant part. What is relevant is the fact that, like I said, I don't know. I've been debating on how I'm going to record these old games, these beautiful old platforming games, because I'm definitely going to. It has to happen. And now that I've talked about it, it would make zero sense to not play them, right? Like, I talked them all up, and I was like, oh, these are important games of my childhood, and I love these games growing up. But also, I'm never going to play them for you. You're never going to see these games be played by me, ever. Is there nothing here? This looks like a Disneyland area. Doesn't this look like Fantasyland? Goodbye, dragon. Alright. I don't know, it looks like... It's giving me Fantasyland vibes. Never been to Disneyland. I'm sorry. I don't know what to say. I'm missing out? Sorta? Kinda? Barely? If that?
Hi, Spyro.
Yeah, I know what that does. Ah, you want me to do that. Excuse me. What's up, Matt? All right, goodbye. Yup. Grab that. Where'd I see that thing? Is it over here? Shit. Oh, it's over here. You have to have the fancy fire to break these. Yeah. How am I still missing some? What? Pretty sneaky there. All right. Yeah, adding Sparx to showing you where stuff is a very useful tool. And I'm surprised I cannot believe they didn't add that until this game, like until Spyro 3. The remaster has it in all of them, but like the fact that it didn't exist prior to the remaster in all the games is like, oh god. You wanted your players to do what now? What? How did I miss this? That was the last one. Of course it was. All right, so that's it. Right? Catch the thief. Oh, right. So. Give me 1 second. Let me get my handy-dandy fire. Because as you know, there's no reason to go about this the normal way. Now we can burn the person to death. Where is he? Wait, where the hell is he? What? Am I crazy? Where the hell did he go? I'm not... There he is. Oh, he goes away when you have the fucking fire, so that way you can't get him. Lame. Lame. Alright, let's go do Sergeant Byrd while we're here. Because obviously, that's the most important one.
I have to train the hummingbirds. They must be in peak physical condition if we're going to take on the sorceress.
Sure.
The situation is this. Yesterday, at 1845 hours, the Reinox invaded. We defended as best we could, sir. But without your leadership, we couldn't put up an effective resistance. By 1900 hours, the rest of the squad was captured, and the Reinox had complete control of the base.
Look at this floppy-ass dumb bird. such a little goober. At least the missiles are tracking. You're free. Okay. Yeah, don't ask how a penguin can fly. He just can. It's fine. I feel bad for that plant. He just like died. All right. Throw a plant at me? I don't know how to use the Y. There's supposed to be a Y feature that you use to blow those up. Am I crazy? This one there was. I'm sorry, did that bug just explode upon looking at me?
Sir, I've captured the enemy rations. They won't march far on empty stomachs. Sir, the Rhinox have blocked the way out of this next cave with a security door. And I don't think you'll be able to blast your way through this one. I recommend you land on the weights and carry them to the pressure-sensitive security switches on either side of the door. When in position, press the charge button to drop the weight. Press the act.
That's what it is. What? The hell is this guy? What? Is there a purpose to killing him? Or did I just kill him for no reason? Ah, you have to be in the air for the gophers to come out. Ah, gotcha. He is just like, oh! The other weight go? There it is. I love the cartoonish anvil dropping. Onto a gopher? Is that all of them? Gosh, dang it. Alright. Now what's up over here, Byrd?
Request submission to cheer, sir! Hip hip hooray!
How are these guys effective fighters? They only have, like, they don't have any arms or missiles or anything. They're just flying. It seems pointless. Shit. Is he shooting a plunger? Kind of cartoonish. Let's see. Where is... Okay, so... Oh, there's another Rhinox. Get out of here. Ah. So the missiles do not target the gopher. Gopher can only be killed by mallets or by anvils. Gotcha. Okay. Well, that ruins that. Hey!
To have your back, sir.
Yeah, better be. All right, well, kind of took me out of the world here. Hello? There we go. Then I need to free you. I think I did that already, did I not? There's still hummingbirds that are trapped? Ah. Oh my god. Oh my god, this goes all the way up. He has limited ammo? Where? Isn't that like his excuse for not breaking out? I was like, oh, I got limited ammo. What the fuck? Sir, I think you lied. Oh my god. That seems unnecessary, honestly. Like, it seems gratuitous to blow up a fucking gopher with a bomb. I mean, it's very American, but still. Still gratuitous. Alright, let's go kill this last gopher. Is that it? Oh, there might be some gophers back in the further. Is there anything else up here? Ah. There was. Okay. So that gopher's dead. Oops. Oh. To show you some debriefs. Get on out of here. Is that all the hummingbirds? Why? Alright. Well, I'm gonna fly on out of here. Get these gems. There has to be. Is there another gopher somewhere? My brain just make up more gophers. Alright. Looks like my dumb brain made up more gophers. Could have sworn. Oh, you know what? I bet there's one. There's one probably at the very end in the area where the enemies were. Also, man, flying is really awkward with this guy. Because it's a slow ascent and a slow descent. So I guess the ascent's a lot slower than the descent, but still, it's pretty slow. So it feels weird going between the two. And you don't run very fast either. This character's just very low mobility, which is funny given it's a flying character. So you'd think that would give it the most mobility. But it also makes me not anxious, but like annoyed thinking about having to perform levels with this guy, because they're gonna take like half an hour to do just in his stupid slowness alone. Yep, there it is. I knew there was another gopher somewhere. Rascally rabbit. Yep. There we go. Oh. Nice. Okay. Now we can head out. Oh. There we go. It's safe. Skill point acquired. Nice. All right, let's finish this up and get the hell out of here, shall we? I'm getting done with this damn level already. Running. Grab the thing. Let's go. Even though I walked close to that gem and it didn't grab it automatically, you fuck. Where? Down. Okay. Is that the one I'm missing? Oh my god, I'm missing like a whole, there's a whole area somewhere. Okay. Weird. Well, that's gonna be it for me though. I gotta take care of something anyway, so I'll come back to this in a little bit. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and goodbye.